Hello, welcome to this video showing you how to use our pin putter. The first thing you need to do is to go to the website. When you get to the website, you enter your username and password given to you. So I'll enter my username, which is always a phone number. Then the next thing is your password. So when you finish entering your username and password, you have to click sign in. So if you forgot your password, you come here and click on forgot password. So when you click on it, it will give you two options. Say it, enter your email or phone number. So you enter anyone you can remember. So when you enter your email, in case you cannot remember the very email you are using, then you put your phone number, then to show you your email, then you click submit, then the default password will be sent to your email. Then you can now check your email, use that password to log in. So when you log in successfully, then you can go back and change the password to your desired format. So having done that, let's go back to the default login page. So I'll enter my username and password. So this is the default page when you sign into your account. So the first thing for you to do is to put money in your wallet to fund your wallet instantly. So you can see it says register bank account. You can see the instruction there, it says register your bank account by clicking register bank account. So that should be the first thing before you can go ahead and make payments. So that bank account you want to move money from into our company account, that is the account you have to register for. So you can register more than one account. Anytime you want to pay, anywhere you have money, then you will register that account in case it's not part of your account already registered before. If you are using something new, you have to register it for the very first time. So you just click on it, register bank account, then to bring out the form for you to fill. So you just enter just the account number is needed, the 10 digit account number. So let me just enter any 10 digits, 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8 9 0. So let's just assume this is my 10 digit account number. Then I'll just click register bank account number. That's so you don't need to enter bank name, whatever. So when you do that, you can now go ahead and make your payment either via transfer or whatever means, provided that money is coming out from that source you have registered. So any account you have registered will be inside this place, register bank account. So when you click on it, you'll be able to see all your bank accounts already registered inside your account. So in case you know that you want to move money from another source, it's not part of the registered account, what you just need to do is to enter new one so you can have more than one account registered inside. So when you make that payment, that money reflects inside this your wallet balance. So that is just a simple way to fund your wallet. So when you have money in your wallet, you can go ahead and place order, that is to take any pin you want at any time, provided you have the money to complement your request. So what you need to do is to go to the next one, which is orders, that is you want to place a order. So when you click on it, it will bring out the page. This is where you can use the calendar to filter to know the orders you've placed. So for first time or for a new order, you click on it, click create order. So when you click on create order, it will bring out the page. You can see it now. When you just read this page, you can see it says click on add product and all that. So this is the add product. So when you click on it, it will bring out the network page for you to now select all the networks we have here in Nigeria. So when you just do that, you can see inside this drop down arrowhead, when you click on it, it will show you all the networks we have here in Nigeria. So you can select any one at a time. So if I want Nine Mobile, for instance, let's say Nine Mobile 200, and I click on it, that means I've selected this one to be Nine Mobile 200. Then the other one says quantity. You see this box now, quantity, you will see default one there. So you can enter the quantity you want to buy. If I say I want to buy one, I'll leave it at 20. If I want to buy 10, I'll enter 10. If I want to buy 100, I enter 100. If I want to buy 1,000, 10,000, I enter the quantity I want. So let's work with just 10, for instance. So when you finish entering the number you want, it says click on save. So you now click on save. When you click on save, the system will save it for you and to show you if it's available inside our network or not. You see it, so you can see it available. So any time you say available, it will show you that you can go ahead and confirm and print. So it means it's available inside the system. So you can take it one network at a time, which is what I recommend, or you can add more. So look at it, add products. You can now add more. Let's say I want maybe 9 mobile 100 denomination. I come here, I add it. But I recommend you are taking it one by one so you can print it without having obstacle. So if I want maybe 100 denomination 10, I'll type the quantity, then I'll now come here and click on save. So when you do that, you can say it available as well. So if I say okay, just these two I want now, I will just go ahead and click confirm and print. So that's just the only way. So when I do it, this total order total, which is the total value of the product I want to buy now, will be deducted from my wallet balance. So if I have up to the amount to withstand my transaction, the money will be debited from my wallet balance and the product will be released to me. So if I click confirm and print, it will take me to this page, which is something like this. You see it? Then the voucher will be displayed for me. Look at it, says open with your login password. So this is where you are to use your login password to unlock your voucher. So you can print 20 per page, 40 per page, or 60 per page. Those are the three options. So you have the right to select anything you want, 20, 40, or 60 per page. So when you just click on the PDF file, it will ask you to enter your password just like normal PDF. Then your voucher will now be displayed to you. So it will come out like this. You see, this one is 100 vouchers. So this is how you know the quantity of vouchers you have. The reference number, you see this part of reference number, to show you the number from number one, number two, that's how you number your vouchers up to the final number. So if we go down now, you see it's reference number one, reference number two, the same way it continues down to the final number. Like here, this one is 100 vouchers. So if we come down, you see it's reference number 100. So this is how you count the number of vouchers you have using the reference number. So it show you the time, the date, the minute it was printed. So that is just how your vouchers will be arranged by the system. So having seen that, you can use your wallet to take PIN at any point in time. The next thing for me to show you is just to understand all these features we have here. So if you maybe after looking at all this, you don't want to do it again, you can delete the order. Provided you've not used this confirm order button, so you can delete it and maybe you want to change your mind and select another thing. So that's just how to use these orders. Then this other part is just payment. Payment will show you all your transactions, the payments you've made in the past and the present one. It will show you all of it. There's always a date for you to navigate and see your transactions. So the next one is talking about profile. Profile is just like you to enter your unique company name and address. So look at it, this company name spot is editable. So you can type in anything you want, then you finish typing, you enter apply changes. So we recommend you don't put any address, just put only your company name there and there, come down and click apply changes. So this is another spot you can use to change your password. So this portal is very easy to use, something anybody can easily navigate through just by reading the features. Be able to see it. Then this front page, just to show you, this one is talking about watch tutorial videos, to watch video about how to use the portal. Then all your payments, you can view them here, the history, there is another shortcut. Then view orders too, this is another shortcut. So this is just a simple way on how to use the portal. Thank you for your time. and have a nice day.